It's a major diplomatic win for India just days before the BRICS summit in Beijing, which Prime Minister Modi will be attending. Disengagement of troops from both sides in the Doklam Plateau, disputed between Bhutan and China. And more importantly, China has pulled the bulldozers meant for road construction out of this area, which was a major concern for India.
It was the worst border standoff between India and China in decades, and now it's over. This morning, the Ministry of External Affairs suddenly announced that the Doklam face-off had ended. Sources in the government telling NDTV that the breakthrough came after weeks of diplomatic negotiations. The MEA said, following diplomatic communications, expeditious disengagement of border personnel of India and China at the face-off site at Doklam is almost completed under verification. The tension began in June when Indian troops entered the plateau claimed by both Bhutan and China to stop China from building a new road, which New Delhi viewed as a serious security concern. Since then, about 300 soldiers from each side had been locked in a confrontation. Government sources have told NDTV that the Chinese bulldozers have moved out of Doklam and the road construction has stopped. This was the main bone of contention. The Chinese Foreign Ministry, when asked today if there had been a mutual disengagement of troops, said that in accordance with the changes of the situation on the ground, China will make necessary adjustments and deployment in accordance with those changes. The Chinese statement was careful not to comment on a withdrawal by their troops, which amounts to a total U-turn in Beijing's position.
8月28日，印方将越界人员和设备全部撤回边界印方一侧，中方现场人员对此进行了确认，中方将继续按照历史界约规定行使主权权利，维护领土主权。
The end of the standoff comes just days before Prime Minister Modi leaves for the BRICS summit in China, which was certain to have been overshadowed by India-China tensions. It's still not clear what exactly made Beijing back down, but Indian officials believe the BRICS summit would have been a key factor. In New Delhi, Nidhi Razdan for NDTV.